Division 2, but this hybrid skill damage build is not what you think. It's actually a DPS build, a special one tailored to the uniqueness of the Capacitor Exotic AR. It's characterized best by its amazingly fast time to kill, one of the best in fact. It's so fast you're going to think you're wearing glass cannon, but you're not, and when facing very difficult content, that's often the difference between surviving or not. No doubts, this build absolutely destroys overall content, and the time to kill is perfect for soloing Legendary. But if you want to have the most kills in Legendary group play, then you're going to want to roll with this one. This build video is going to be a tad bit different than others. We're going to look under the hood of the Capacitor to determine why it's more powerful than it appears. Then I'm going to create a build around those strengths so you can see my thought process as I create these setups for you banditos. Figured out how super powerful the exotic capacitor assault rifle is yet? I know you've used it, but have you realized how strong it is? And I don't mean the 60% damage it gives your skills, that speaks for itself. If you put as many miles on your capacitor as I have, then you've probably said to yourself at some point, damn, this thing shreds. We're going to figure out why this gun hits harder than it looks. Then we're going to lean into it with a build that's designed around the capacitor's strengths to make it shred like it's never done before. The devs gave us a gift from the gods with this exotic AR. It hits hard, synergizes with your skills, and its aim is true. Let's take a look under the hood of this AR. So it has a 700 RPM, 40 rounds in the mag within 1.8 second reload. All of these stats are on the lower side for an AR. Many assault rifles have an extended mag mod that pushes them up to 50 rounds. In fact, I suspect the small mag on the capacitor is why some don't realize how powerful it is. It's common to evaluate the strength of a weapon based on how many enemies it can take down with a single mag, and weapons with a small mag might appear to be weak because of the consequential reload. So when the capacitor is taking down elites in a single mag, and multiple non-elites in a single mag, using 10 rounds less than most ARs, I say you should be impressed. With this assault rifle, the devil is in the details. Look at the attributes. The cores are assault rifle damage and damage to armor. Wait, that's different for an assault rifle, isn't it? Most ARs come with 21% health damage. This has 12% damage to armor, like a shotgun. The secondary attribute is 9.5% health damage. Remember, damage to armor and health damage are multiplicative, not additive damage. The talent capacitance is twofold. It gives your skills 60% more damage, but it also gives the AR 7.5% more damage per skill tier. Look closely at the mods. The optical scope gives you 10% crit chance, the muzzle gives you 30% crit damage, huge, and the grip gives you 10% weapon handling. Look at the accuracy and stability stats. Those are pretty impressive for a weapon with this damage output. Think about that. So although you have a smaller mag, you're landing more of your critical shots, and your total reload time is fast. So, the secret recipe to incredible power is simple. It's base weapon damage plus crit damage, damage to armor, and health damage. What happens if we fully spec into those with a build? Well, that's what we're about to do. I tinkered with this build for a long time, and this is where I landed. You can move some pieces around here and there to tweak it to your playstyle, and I encourage you to do that. Hey, if you're looking to play the Division 2 in new and exciting ways, this is the right channel. Join my Discord for more action and consider becoming a member of Texas Players Club. It's only a buck. Don't miss out. Hit the join button below to get started. Also, if you dig what I'm putting down, I'd appreciate the like, comment, and a subscribe. This helps me help you, and I have lots more where this came from. Okay, so the idea is to build to the specs of the AR, and the first attribute is assault rifle damage. So for the chest, I'm running Fenris for 10% more assault rifle damage. The capacitor weapon damage is boosted by 7.5% for every skill tier, so I rolled on a skill tier to this chest piece, and I have crits throughout. The talent, kinetic momentum, gives my skills 15% more damage each. I prefer the ferocious calm, which you can get from the DZ or by farming named item caches. This video shows you how to farm DZ exclusive gear without stepping 1 foot in the dark zone. Ferocious Calm has perfect overwatch, which gives your skills and weapon 12% more damage when you're in cover after 8 seconds. Go with a Fenris chest piece and the non-perfect version of overwatch if you don't have the Ferocious Calm. It actually feels really good, better than kinetic momentum in fact. I didn't have a version of Fenris with this talent where I could roll on the skill tier, so I couldn't afford to use it. But if you can, go that route instead. Glass Cannon also works, but it didn't give me enough boost in my time to kill to make it worth it. I mean, it's hard to tell the difference between really, really fast and really, really, really fast, if you know what I mean. This is a fight from cover build, so any of these talents will work, even Spark, which gives your weapon 15% more damage when your skills are putting out damage. Since I'm fighting from cover and killing so quickly, I decided to stick to just relying on armor kits. I didn't add any additional repair skills or armor regen. To buff the assault rifle damage more, I'm running Walker and Harris from my backpack. This gives us 5% more weapon damage. It's all red with crits. You can also put on the skill tier if you like. To balance out the skill power, I'm running combined arms, which gives our skills 25% more damage. That hits really hard undeniably, and this build intends to utilize the primary weapon just as much as the skills, so this talent is perfect. Remember, the capacitor has crit chance and crit damage mods, so we're building on that too throughout the build. I started with the memento backpack, and it worked as good as you could imagine. It gives you a little more survivability if you want to go that way, but I felt a little more powerful this way without having to have full trophy stacks. Also wanted you to be happy with this build, solo and in group, and some of you don't prefer the memento in group play. Try both, go with what you love. Be sure to join me live on YouTube. I stream for Players Club members on Thursdays and open it up for the entire community on Saturdays. There's a lot of good knowledge nuggets in these for you. If you miss me live, head over to my channel to watch the replay. The next attribute on the AR is damage to armor. So to boost that, I went with the contractor's gloves, which gives me 8% more damage to armor. If you can, find one with skill damage already on it and then roll on a skill tier. I would prefer that version myself. My knee pads are my second piece of Walker, which is giving me another 5% damage to armor. I have crits and a skill tier rolled on it. We are now at a total of 25% damage to armor. I tinkered with this piece of ton. I tried several versions, one with crit damage, a skill tier, and skill damage. I felt the crits were more important here because the build has enough buffs going to skill damage. The build has the best of skill damage bonuses. In fact, health damage is the next attribute on the assault rifle. To maximize that, I'm running the Hollow Man mask. It has a special 10% health damage attribute on it. Mine has skill damage, crit chance, and I rolled on a skill tier. We are now at 20% in total health damage. This is also a DZ exclusive item. If you don't have this piece or don't want to farm it, then you can put a third piece of Walker here for 5% health damage instead. Lastly, to stay on theme of boosting the capacitor's strengths, the capacitor's talent works to boost our skill damage by 60%. So for the holster, I chose the waveform exotic, which teeter-totters an additional 30% skill damage on top of the attributes. This plus the kinetic momentum's 15% bonus plus 25% from combined arms, which is on our backpack, totals 70% in skill damage bonuses. So with the capacitor, that's 130% skill damage bonus in total. Plenty. If we take one last look at the capacitor details, we see these two mods that are giving us crit chance and crit damage. We built on that throughout the setup, and we landed at 55% crit chance and 108% crit damage. That doesn't sound like a lot, but remember, what makes this AR so strong is the stacking of multiplicative damage. That is the engine behind this build. We ended up with 25% total armor damage and 20% total health damage. Here's a peek at the base skill stats. Remember, these are before the bonuses. I am running Technician for an extra skill tier and extra damage to robotics. Remember to activate the 10% skill damage modifier. And the power is just undeniable. Seriously, it feels like I'm running Glass Cannon. It's hitting that hard. It's adequate for all scenarios. Solo heroic, legendary, group play, whatever. Another classified build is dropping this week. I'm really excited to share it with you, Banditos. It's gonna be an eye-opener. If you don't know, classified builds are secret builds made just for Tux's Players Club true and hardcore Bandido member levels. If you want to tap into these, you can get access today by hitting the join button below. I'm going to show you some solo legendary too. I'm doing this just to demonstrate how strong it is, but there are challenges with running legendary solo. You can run the risk of running out of ammo and medkits. So if you are a solo legendary player, you might want to go with glass cannon and the memento to compensate for that. This will give your skills and gun more power so you can use less ammo and 3% regen from those trophies so you don't always need your medkits. That aside, this clears enemies like one of the greats. Can you believe how fast those tanks go down? Clearing this is going to be easy, just as easy as any other build, but the biggest threat will be those drone operators. Here's a tip, to get the most out of this build, focus fire your skills and your primary weapon on the same target. Try not to divide and conquer too much. This will not only keep your time to kill at an all-time low, but it will also save you on ammo and keep your skills in check. If you let your drone go autonomous, it can wander out of range or find itself taking the force of the entire enemy horde, which it can't handle. Keeping it near or on target will help protect it and ensure it stays up to its maximum potential. If you don't keep the turret in check, sometimes it locks on an unobtainable target and won't let go, which basically makes it useless. Look how many non-elites are in legendary, and we have 20% health damage. That's going to melt them fast. That's also going to help us with the robotics and weak points, even the Chungas. This build has it all, and the recipe was right there in the capacitor. I wanted to walk you through this process because many of you ask me how I come up with my builds, and this is one of the ways. Sometimes the weapon, exotic, or gear set have details that can be enhanced with other pieces that synergizes with the attribute. Like the capacitor, it has stacking multiplicative damage, and we're leaning into that with this build. So next time you're looking to create a build, find a piece you're going to build around. Maybe it's a chest piece, maybe it's an exotic or a weapon or a skill. Look at the details of that item and try to pull in things that complement it. Complements come in many forms. They can boost the attribute's strengths, or they can balance the build out with a different attribute on the opposite side of the spectrum. The Tux clans are popping, and we recently opened up the PC and PlayStation clans for agents looking to experience the Division 2 in new and more exciting ways. In a time when clans are dying, these clans are thriving. It's more than just raids and group ups. These banditos also take down the Mission Impossible challenges together. Easiest place to connect with them is on my Discord. Ping XLatina or the admin to make an intro once you arrive. New and experienced agents welcome. You all know me well enough by now to know I do whatever I can to not use my armor kits. So having a build without regen self-sufficiency built in some form gives me a little itch. I never ran out of kits running over 20 heroic control points. You always get new kits dropping, but running legendary solo I did, which would be fine if I didn't play so damn aggressive. To bring regen, something's gotta give. What would you change? You're getting so many kills, I think armor on kill might be the best way. So you could bring in the death grips with the skill tier and skill damage. If you wanted armor regen, you might think about trying the memento, also because it brings in an armor core. You have options. For me, I decided to keep it just as it is because the power, it feels oh so good. If you want to carry your team through legendary but controlling the crowd with status effects that don't rely on skills, that don't have cooldowns, then you gotta check out this build that runs a Scorpio exotic shotgun in a very different way than you'd expect.
TuxedoBandido out.